Okay, so what we have is approximately 5 meters of this net fabric, and what I've done is folded this in four. Okay, and then this is the unselvaged edge. This is the unselvaged edge, and I'm going to take that corner, straighten it all out, make sure that all the pieces are aligned. Basically, just put a couple of pins just to keep this firmly in place before I take it and shake it about a little bit. Now, we have got a little bit of lack of space here. The wider your space, the easier it'll be to do. Really, you want space all around your table to easily access the cutting, but unfortunately, being restricted on the space, we only have this much space. Okay, so what we're going to do is, that's where we're going to take our top portion of the sharara out from, and here is where we're going to do all the cutting. Okay, so what we're going to do is, first of all, take this length of what this is and measure. So what we have here is approximately 48 inches. I'm going to go 47 inches, okay? And I'm going to mark it at 47 inches. And then I'll keep hold of this end, and I'm just gonna go, keep going around, measuring 47. And that's basically the bottom gear of the sharara. Now, the only thing that I've got to bear in mind is, have I got enough to make? And it doesn't really matter. We can, even if we have to join a few pieces to get that, I'm sure we can work that out. So this is the round gear that we're going to cut around. I know you're not going to be able to see this. Once you've marked it out, you can fine line it a bit more, so you just know what you're cutting. So that's the bottom gear that we're going to cut, and then we're going to cut upwards from that. So, and that's where the gathers are going to cut. This is, you know, the wider you, the more bottom you cut from. Like this fabric has got a big gear. There was a jamawar one that I'd cut earlier on, and the width on that was a lot less. So from the bottom upwards, when I was measuring, I couldn't get that far up. So I didn't have as many gathers here on the knee area as I wanted. But the bottom gear. Now, the one other thing that you've got to bear in mind is, I've got lace to go with this. And in total, I have got lace pieces of approximately, just need to make sure before I cut into this, because I need to make sure that I've got adequate lace to go all the way around. So I've got that, and you know what, I need four times the size of this. So we're just going to run a little bit short, and for that, what we can do is, you know, rather than cutting here, we can go up a little and we can make this gear a little bit less. Okay, and that would mean that as we go cutting further up again, we will make it less. I just want to make sure that this is so. Yeah, so what we have is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, so four times the amount of this is the lace we need. So if I was to go less, if I was to go about there, I'm still going just a little bit short, but I think I'm gonna go for just the slightly less amount. Otherwise, I won't have enough lace to go. So initially, we made this at 40. Initially, we've measured this at 47. We're going to go for 40. Okay, we're going to go for 40. So I'm dropping off 7 inches because that what I'm going to have is I'm not going to have enough lace to go around all the bottom of the gear of the Sharara. So we're going to drop away 4 inches. Now what that's going to mean is if you're using loose lace, then obviously you can buy the lace and you can make it as wide as you want. But because this is pre-supplied, we're limited to what we can do. Now, not to worry, this will still give us a nice wide gear, and I'll just show you what the gear of this will be. Yeah, even this is slightly less, but what I'll do is I'll slightly use ease of the hand when I'm applying, and this width of the gear is approximately 3 meters. So you've got 3 meters and 3 meters on either of the legs. If I was to use the 47 inch one, then the gear would be, okay, so you've got meter, that would make it 4 meters. So another extra meter of lace is what I would have required if I was to do that. Now, I will apply this on to the bottom of this. So bearing that in mind, I'm going to work out what the length of my sharara is going to be. So I want this about from the ankle to the knee area. I needed this 19. I'm just going to go for a slightly higher 22 inches from the bottom. 22 inches. So about 20 inches of this I'm going to cut around. So first of all, we're going to take away this excess. This is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So 20 inches. Hello, Yahya. Hello, Yahya. How are you, Yahya?
Hello.
Hello, Budur. Ji, Budur. Ji. Where did I go? I didn't go anywhere.
Your car?
My car is still outside.
What?
You've seen my car. It's outside.
I see it.
Yes, you have seen it.
Yeah, I see it.
How are you feeling? Are you feeling any better? Is the bit that's going to get all the gathers. And this is the bit that's going to have the border attached. And then we've got to cut the top portion. And we've got plenty of material left over now. As you saw, we did away with the... What are you shouting at? What's Sarah doing? What's your sister doing? Shout at me.
Yeah.
Why are you gonna shout at me for? You don't shout at me.
Why I'm gonna call him and say, okay, then I'll be your friend.
Then you're gonna be my friend?
Yeah.
Okay. If you can go in my car, then you're gonna be my friend.
Then there's nothing in the car.
Have you ever been to university today? So this is the top portion of the skirt. I'm just running just a little bit short. I'm just going to add just a small amount of piece, just enough to do the turning in this. And then this, I don't want to keep it too tight. I want it nice and wide on the thigh area. And this is the back of the, it's a little bit like a trouser cut. I've cut the one. I'm gonna just place this on top of this spare piece of fabric and cut the next one. Hopefully it should be adequate. Before I go cutting the lining, you can use any trouser template if you want to cut like this. I know this is going in the opposite directions, but it really doesn't matter. Yeah, this one was just a little bit short, so the next one, it's a little bit difficult to see on this as well. Both the fabrics are the same. And we're going to have just enough for extension. Like in a normal trouser cut, what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut the back crotch longer than the front. This is the front crotch, and like I mentioned, the front one of the pieces was just a little bit shorter. I was going to add a little bit of a piece on top of that, so bearing that in mind, I'm going to cut the other one just slightly. Legs. If I just give you a little bit of a description of what I've done, that's the leg piece that's going to be attached on to this. And that border is going to get attached to the bottom of that. This is all going to have these gathers in this to give this a nice wide flowy look. And just get a final length on this. Yeah, finished result, I want this about 39 inches, which is coming out adequate enough. What I will do is I will put the lining with this, and then also the lining with the dress.